Namaskar girls. We are learning Indian economy before and after independence. In the previous class we learn about the Green Revolution. That is the technical breakout of agricultural industries. In the agricultural industries. Today we are going to learn large scale industries. What do you mean by large scale industries? The industries which requires a large amount of investment, that is capital, and using the machineries are called large scale industries, isn't it? So large scale industries, they requires huge infrastructure, the large infrastructure, that will be a big plant, and large manpower, and also huge amount of capital. Some of the large scale industries are iron and steel, textile industry, automobile manufacturing industries. But recently, the information technology industries, the IT industries, are also considered to be one of the large scale industries. Because of the huge amount of revenue generated by the IT industries, it is also included in the large scale industries. If you see the Indian economy, it is mainly depend upon the industries for its GDP. Not only for the GDP economic growth, but also for the foreign currencies and for the employment opportunities and other things. Now let us see about the some of the large scale industries. The first one is iron and steel industry. The first steel industry was established in Kalchi near Jharia, and also Bengal Works Company in West Bengal in the year 1870. So the first iron and steel industry was established in the year 1870. And the first large scale industry, steel plant, first large scale steel plant was established, TISCO, was established in the place Jamshedpur in the year 1907. And the first and it is followed by ISCO at Burnpur in the year 1990. The first large steel scale industry was established at Jamshedpur in the year 1907, TISCO, and ISCO is established in the year 1919 at Burnpur. And the first public sector unit was established as Bhadravati, which is named as Vishveshwaraya Iron and Steel Works. It is the first public sector unit. Public means government unit. All these things are organized and managed by SAIL, S-A-I-L, that is Steel Authority of India Limited. So all the iron and steel industries are managed and organized by Steel and Authority of India Limited, except the TISCO, because It is a private sector. DISCO, which was established in the year 1970, it is a private sector. So it never comes under the control of SEBI. The remaining things comes under the control of SEBI. And presently, India plays the 8th place of the production of steel and iron. So, India is the 8th largest producer of steel in the world. And the next one is jute industry. The next one is jute industry. It is an important industry for a country like India because it not only earns the foreign exchange, but it also provides the employment opportunities both in the agricultural and also industrial sector. So in the industries like jute industries are very much important for our country because it also earns the foreign exchange and it also provides the employment opportunity. And the first modernized jute industry was established as Reshra at West Bengal in the year 1855. And usually the jute industries are traditionally exported oriented. All the things which are made by jute are exported to other parts of the world. So India ranks first in the raw jute production, and it also gets a second place in the production of jute goods, producing jute goods. It gets the first place or first rank in the raw jute, and it gets the second place in the production of jute goods. That is the things which are produced with the help of jute. And the third one is cotton and textile industry. It is considered to be one of the oldest industries, which needs a large number of employees. You all know that, isn't it? The people we all know who are, which is near to our cellar. So many weaving textile mills are there, isn't it? Towels and other things they are preparing. So we can see number of people are working there. Shift basis. On the shift basis, usually in the textile mills, people work on the shift basis. 3 shift will be there. All the 24 hours the machines will run. Because it gives employment to large number of people. And it is also the largest organized and broad-based industry which gets or which contributes the 4% of India's GDP. So 4% of GDP, national income, is provided by the cotton and textile industry. And the first modernized cotton industry was established in the year 1818 at Calcutta. The name of the industry is Fort Gloucester, but it was not successful. It didn't achieve its goal. So the second mill it started, which was named as Mumbai's Spinning and Weaving Co., in the year 1854 by the KGN Dobar. So the first textile industry was established at Calcutta, but it was not successful. The second spinning and weaving mill was established at Mumbai in the year 1854. And the next one is sugar industry. Next one, sugar industry. India is the second largest producer of sugar. It's an agro-based industry, isn't it? The raw material, sugar cane, is obtained from the agricultural department. So, sugar industry is considered to be the agro-based industry. India is the largest, second largest producer of sugar. And if you see the producer, India is the second largest. And also, India is the largest consumer of sugar also. India is the largest producer as well as the largest consumer of sugar. The total production of India's sugar, 1/3 is contributed by Maharashtra. For example, if they are producing totally 600 tons means 200 tons is produced by Maharashtra and the second which is closer Uttar Pradesh. So 1/3 of the total contribution is produced by Maharashtra. And the next one, fertilizer industries. India is the third largest producer of nitrogenous fertilizers. And the next one is paper industry. The first mechanized paper mill was set in 1812 at Srirampur in West Bengal. Here in Tamil Nadu you all know TNPL, Tamil Nadu Paper Industries Limited, near at Karur. So in India, in Tamil Nadu also we are having the paper industry, TNPL. You all know that, I think so. While we are taking the Xerox and other things, we see that paper industry's name, paper mill name. And in India is ranked, or India has a position of 15th in the top global industries, paper industries. India, in the paper production, India ranked 15th position. And the next one, silk industry. India is the second largest producer of silk material. First place goes to China. And India is the second largest producer of natural silk. From we are taking the silk from the silkworm. You all studied in science, isn't it, girl? Cocoons and other things. Silkworm. So, we are the second largest producer of the natural silk. First place goes to China. Second place, India. And altogether, total production of silk, India is contributing 60% of silk production. In the global level, we are contributing 16% of production of silk is contributed by India. And we are also known the 5 different distinction varieties. India is famous for 5 distinction varieties of silk. That I have given: mulberry, tropical tusser, oak tusser, eri and buga silks. These are the very famous silks produced in India. Different varieties of silks production. And the next one, petroleum and natural gas. The first oil well was dug in Big Boy, Assam in the year 1889. Oil well. Now UAE is famous for that oil, petroleum and oil products. But we do have the oil well. It was dug. It was dug in the year Big Boy in the year 1889 at Assam. And presently number of regions are there which have the oil resources. Don't think that this is no organs are there which have identified the oil and they are extracting the oil resources. For the exploration purpose, we have a commission, ONGC, Oil and Natural Gas Commission, which was established in the year 1956 at Dehradun, Uttarakhand. So they are the responsible for the oil exploration, ONGC, Oil and Natural Gas Commission. So these are all the large scale industries. First one, iron and steel, jute, cotton and textile, sugar, fertilizer, paper, silk and petroleum and natural gas. These are all considered to be large scale industries which needs huge infrastructure, large human power, manpower, machinery power and also large amount of capital. The next one we are going to see is small scale industries. Next we are going to see small scale industries. Large scale industries, they require huge infrastructure, large manpower and also large amount of capital. Small scale industries, they do not require huge infrastructure or large scale of capital, but it plays an important role for the development of an economy. Nearly 60 to 70% of innovations come only from the small scale industries. New things, new method of productions and other things. Today we are seeing so many business people, very big business people, but those people who are considered to be a business magnates nowadays are only a small scale industries or small entrepreneurs once. They started their business in a small and now they have enlarge them as a big business. We all hear about the VGP brothers and Vasant and Co and others. In their early period, they started their business in a small scale, as a small scale industries. Later, they expanded their industries. Nowadays, they are considered to be the big business magnates. The earlier period, they sold their goods in the monthly basis, installments and other, everything we hear, isn't it? So, today's business, big business magnates are once a small entrepreneur, small scale entrepreneurs. And then we are going to see the role of small scale industries in the economic development. What are the things we get from the small scale industries, how far it is useful for the economic development. And the first one is provide employment. Already I told India is rich in human capital, manpower, isn't it? So the goods which are produced with the help of the labor or the labor intensive goods are very much produced in small scale industries. By employing those people, the problem of unemployment is very much solved. Many people are engaged in the small scale industries. For example, if you see Sivagasi area, Sathur and other, we can see the people, those are working in the match factory, crackers factory, and even now we can see axillo, isn't it? I already told you. The small weaving, textile industries. So now large number of people are engaged in small scale industries. So that many people got employment. And it is also provide employment to the artisans, technically qualified, and the people, those who are doing the traditional arts, handicrafts, and others. For example, pottery. People, those who are doing the pottery works, matchbox. All those comes under making the puppets, appala pandrathu, oorga podrathu, everything comes under this. So those things help people to engage themselves. And it also, the employment capital ratio is very high in the small scale industries. And the second one, it brings the balanced regional development. All the regions are equally developed. For example, if you take South Usmavasi and others, they are doing the match crackers and other things. If you take Madurai, they are doing these things. If you take Dindigul and other areas, they too have some small scale industries business. Ginning factories are there. So almost all the regions are equally developed with the help of the small scale industries. Because most of the small scale industries are set up in the backward and the rural areas. Because of the resources or the less rent, large space, number of employment opportunities. So these things play an important role for the balanced regional development. So if they started a small scale industry in the outside of the areas, all the people, those who are there in that areas, they will get opportunity, employment opportunity. Then they can improve their standard of living also, isn't it? And it also helps to remove the regional disparities. The same thing only. We cannot, while we are comparing the regions, which is better or best. So while we are balancing, if all the regions have the small scale industries, almost all the regions will get this equal importance. So it helps to remove the regional disparities. Because of, I already told, they set up in the backward and the rural areas, by that they can enhance their areas. And they also reduce the problem of congestions, slum, sanitation and pollution in cities, isn't it? Almost I told, all the small scale industries are usually found in the outside of the cities, so that we can reduce the problem of these things. And they also help to improve the standard of living of the people in the suburban and the rural areas. Already I told the people, that in those areas they will get the employment opportunity, by that they can improve their standard of living. By earning, by income, they will improve their standard of living. And it also helps to equal importance to the income distribution, because the entrepreneurs, technically sound,
or expert entrepreneurs, they used to start their business in the area which they have to spend only less amount of expenses. So they started their small scale industries in the different regions, and thereby the people of that area, they will get the income. So the income is not accumulated only in the city side, it is also distributed to the village, rural areas and the suburban areas also. So there will be an equal distribution of income. And the third one, it helps in the mobilization of local resources. So it helps to mobilize and utilize the local resources like small savings, talents and other things. For example, if a person, one who starts a small scale industries in the outskirts of the cities, a person who is interested to start a business will be encouraged or attracted by the person who started earlier, and he too started to do the business. So thereby his resources, the idle resources, particularly the idle resources, that means which is not used till date, those resources will be utilized. For example, if a person in a village area, he has wealth, a large amount of saving, but he is not doing any business, he stored this money . So if he is attracted by an entrepreneur, a small scale industry entrepreneur, he too invested his stored money, thereby his money will be utilized for the productive measures, which won't be idle. பயப்படுத்தப்படாமல் வச்சிருந்த பணத்தை என்ன செய்ய முடியும்? If they are investing in the small scale industries, they can utilize. Thereby they can give employment opportunities to many people. Thereby they can increase their money, isn't it? So the small scale industry